You're watching PEGRI TV, Rhode Island's public access channel.
Welcome, everybody, to Figures R Us, your official wrestling collector show from the Official Wrestling Museum. We are your hosts. I am Angel, and I'm joined by the Official Wrestling Museum's Hall of Famer,
Mo Live.
And we're here this week talking about rings. Before we jump into a ring, we need to talk about something that's passed on. The late, great Kevin Sullivan. Our thoughts and prayers goes out to his family and fans and friends. He definitely, when he was in the ring, all the storytelling to lead to those entrances to the ring and being in the ring was just on a different level, and he's going to be greatly missed. Great, great guy. We even did a private signing with him through COVID. Went very, very well. He was just old school, really great.
Boston guy.
Yeah.
Man, great minds, Boston guy. Love the
huge
Red
loss.
Sox.
Huge, huge loss.
Yeah.
So scan that QR code, because that QR code is for guys like him, in honoring him on a very special day, a National Pro Wrestling Day. Your help, it's totally free. It takes about 10 seconds to do.
I was going to say, you know, actually, the San Francisco Toy Makers, when they made the LJM ripoffs for WCW, they actually do have a vibrating Kevin Sullivan.
Yeah, they do. Yep. That was always the weirdest thing. Yeah. I never understood the purpose of them besides
the vibrating? It was just something, I don't know.
It's just being different. At that time, WWE and WCW was competing on what they could put out in the shows. They really were. Somebody took a bump.
Kevin Sullivan.
Yeah.
The ghost right there.
So, rings are one of the most popular item if you're going to say it's worth money. It
I mean,
really is.
Even above that, like, if you have wrestlers, you have to have a ring. Like, if you don't have a ring, yeah, in your mind you can play, but you need at least one ring, you know?
You do. And there's been so many rings throughout the years. Rings, no matter what condition they are in, they're always going to be worth money. So if you're looking for a gift for somebody, you don't know what to get, pick up a ring. And if they, you know, trying to sell them, rings are gonna go. Besides
going back,
that, what
going
you
back
were
to
saying,
AWA ring, like that AWA ring now, if you buy that in unboxed, like, or I mean boxed but unopened, I mean, didn't Zack Ryder just buy one, like the ring with the six rings for like $500 or something?
That's a crazy amount.
And that ring, and the thing about that, so if we, you know, that AWA ring was awesome. But the thing about it was just cardboard.
Yeah.
It was cardboard. But it had the canvas. It was awesome. Came with the cage.
Yeah.
The little lock. Like, the details. All about the details. But it was just a piece of cardboard.
Yeah. It really was. And it's funny that things like this, we talk about that a lot. The rings and title belts, the foam belts, the toy belts, are the ones that go for so much money later in life. Everybody wants a ring, like you said. If you're gonna have figures, you gotta have a ring. And there's been some really great rings, and there's been some rings that were just horrible. Like, I remember the WCW ring that they made.
Yeah, we've talked about that.
The ropes, elastic ropes.
Yeah. And the ECW ring was just like that, but they did improve the ropes.
Right. And the bodies, like, it was on the top rope was to the calf. Like, it wasn't good. But then if you're going to jump over to the Monster Ring for the Jack-specific rings,
well, I was gonna say
which was a redo of the LJN.
The LJN ring, they painted black.
Those ropes weren't
Yeah,
they were too high.
Yeah, the guys were so small. Yeah, because the ring was designed for the LJNs, not these 6-inch Jacks guys. And it was like, I remember when they came out, and I remember because the LJN ring was so memorable in the sense of with the corners, how they stuck out. Yep. And I'm like, that's just the same ring. And I'm sitting there going, I wasn't buying Jacks guys at the time, but I was like, why would I want that? I had that years ago.
Right.
My dad put his foot to it. I think I've told that story.
You did tell that story.
I got my dad pretty upset, and he put his foot through my ring. And I was like, we ended up taping it up, and it held up. So, but it was huge. That ring was huge.
That wrestling, the Monster Wrestling, they started to put out, a Roars War one, which is the black one.
For the Jacks,
Then they started to do it with figures, including Undertaker and Stone Cold in one box. They re-reduced it with a referee figure, which I really think WWE drops the ball. Releasing figures of referees. You know what? I'm going to bring this up. I was going to wait for another show when we do like the Mattels and they have all these chases and stuff, right? Wouldn't it a cool idea be instead of doing, okay, here's Randy Orton in black gear, his chase has red gear, right? Wouldn't it be cool if the chase figure is a referee?
Well, here's the problem with that, though. When you're a kid,
yep.
And you say, well, now guys will cost more, but if you were a kid, you had $10 and you know you can get two or three guys, you're really going to be like, okay, I want to go get Hulk Hogan, I want to go get Ultimate Warrior, and I want to get Dave Hebner. You're not really thinking in that way.
You're right.
My son will, though. He ordered one on his own on Amazon.
Back in the day, absolutely. Fully.
But aren't they doing that today with the Jacks now? Didn't they just do a Teddy Long and a Mike?
So they did it, but it's the Build-A-Figure.
Yeah.
And I understand the concept of the Build-A-Figure and you still get the guy. But give them an actual figure. You know what I mean?
I don't know.
First, collectors will collect them all day long. Second, a fan's going to do it. If it's a chase figure too, you don't have to produce as many as you do. So let's just say your product line for WWE is $100 per figure, right? So put your chase out there as $20 or $15. So it's more of a chase. You're going to get people that want to buy them. You're going to get stuff. It doesn't have to just be figures too. I didn't mean to interrupt you on this.
Well,
it doesn't have to be just wrestling referees. It could be your commentators get put in there. It could be a ring announcer gets put. It could be a backstage. Have your chase figure be that extra body that if somebody does want, and if not, okay, it's not a big loss.
I just see it hard for a kid to be like, yeah, Daddy, I got, you know, nowadays where figures are $8, $10, $12, $15, $20, $30. Yeah, Daddy, I want to go out to Toys R Us or Walmart.
Right.
I want to go out and I'm going to get a referee. You know what I mean? Like,
right, but...
And I feel like with kids that actually... You know, when you're talking about the collectors and stuff, that's one thing.
Yep.
But when you're talking about, like, kids, I feel like if a kid has one ref, maybe two, that's all they really need.
And this might not be something to do every single series, you know what I mean? Kind of every couple of series. And you would do it with basics. You want to do it with your elites.
I kind of like that they do it with the Build-A-Figure. It gives you... Like, okay, so if you really want it, you'll get it because you'll buy all the other figures. Like, for me personally, would it be like me going, well, I got to get every figure because I got to get that Teddy Long? No, I probably wouldn't, but that's me. I mean.
But to me, if you're good enough to make a Build-A-Figure, to have that be the marketing tool to sell those four figures, that figure should be a separate figure. You know what I mean? I don't know. That's my opinion.
What do you think about, I know they just did release a Mr. T in the referee shirt. What do you think about that? That's pretty cool.
Okay, it's cool, but why not a Charles Robinson figure? You know what I mean?
What about did Muhammad Ali in the...
Okay, so why couldn't we get a John Crone figure without being a Bill figure? Or a Tim White figure?
Because a kid doesn't really care about Tim White
But you're worrying about... Right now, they're not marketing really to kids. They're marketing to collectors.
No.
That's who they're marketing to.
All right.
So
that's the referee talk. We had the referee talk. Let's get back into rings.
We'll talk about that another day.
Hasbro came out with their rings that were awesome because they were perfect size for the Hasbro. I used my G.I. Joes in those Hasbro rings. I only had the blue, the original.
Only had the blue one?
Yeah, I didn't have that yellow King of the Ring. I look at that. I did not like how it had the flat things on top of the poles. And speaking about the Hasbro ring, they are doing the retros. And so they have re-released the Hasbro ring. And it's the Hasbro ring. Now, this one is just black. They just did a new one with Brother Love coming with the figure. And that's a purplish one. I think they did the original blue one, too.
They did.
Okay, this was the second one they've done then, I think. And I had to pick it up because I figured, why not? It was only, price was pretty decent on it. It was only $20. So
the original ones were cool. They had a JCPenney exclusive that came with Hulk Hogan and Macho Man. They had in 90, they had ones with a black round turnbuckles. They had the black square turnbuckles get re-released that year. And then they also had the blue round turnbuckles, which is basically the one that a lot of people see and know. They did come with an American flag,
and
which was kind of, which was kind of interesting that they added the flag. Oh. I kind of liked it. I didn't.
Yeah.
No hate on
I
that.
I used it.
Me too.
I would have guys get
but
thrown into it.
The belt is where, that was the only place you could get a belt.
Yeah.
Was that?
Right, the belts didn't come
and
with.
And it was only the Wind Eagle.
Yeah.
But that WCW was literally the one that was producing the WCW makeshift logo title on all their figures that you can get.
Yeah.
WWE was like, nope, we're going to just have that come out with the ring. So even if you didn't want a ring at that time, they were banking on the belt being the selling item. And then the King of the Ring one being yellow was really cool as well, too. I had a blue one with the blue turnbuckles and stuff. And then I had the King of the Ring one. And those ropes are really durable. By now, like my blue ring, you know, it's curled up around a bunch of times. But they really stood the test of times, let's say.
There was also another ring I had back then released, not by WWF or anything, Muscles. Do you remember the Muscles ring?
Yeah.
So it was a little tiny yellow ring, and it had two joysticks on it. And it was kind of like, think of Rock'em Sock'em Robots, but small, and you would put a muscle on each one, and you could move it around. I don't know, just a ring I wanted to mention. But then WCW had a couple rings also. They had that garbage one that we talked about.
Yeah.
That came with a red steel cage. That ring was just garbage all around.
It really was.
And then
it
they had the
so easy by their
they had that
too.
Nitro playset, which was pretty cool at the time.
Yeah.
Because at the time they weren't doing like arena playsets, and that was like the best you could get. And then they had like the rare Bash at the Beach one that was like on a inflatable raft. That was pretty. I'd never had it, but that's pretty cool because it makes me think of the Spring Breakout Nitros
in
the pool.
I think their idea was that you could take it into the pool, or in the bathtub, because
that's why it was
the
Bash.
Hence
Bash at the Beach.
And I think that was a really smart marketing idea by WCW.
Yeah.
WWE.
My son would love that now.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
And it's like
my son too.
I think I've looked it up on eBay, and it's super expensive because it's so rare.
Right. Now, WWE will fire back, and they were like, okay, well, we'll do gimmick matches. Let's bring out the cages. Let's bring out the TLC matches. Let's we're going to do a Raw ring, a SmackDown ring. Let's do a Hulk Hogan ring. Let's do a theme rings. And that's what they were doing at that. And it wasn't that it was a bad idea. They were just monopolizing so many different types of rings that it was getting to the point where their prices were going up so high, and parents just weren't buying them because why? Because it comes with this, okay, but this figure comes with that.
Then they started doing, had the Titantron Live playset, and I remember they came out with a SmackDown playset, or a ring that made sounds and stuff. I remember when it came out, we ran to Target or Kmart in South Boston to go grab that, and I was like, I gotta get it. And it was a ring, and it had, like, rafters and... Then Jack started getting into the picture, and you know they were making their rings, but then you had the real scale ring.
Yeah.
When that came out, I had the first one, but it was not made well because they had to make like a version 2 where they had extra clips and stuff.
Yeah.
It was awesome. It was huge, but you really couldn't play on it because it would snap and like fold in half and stuff on you. So
that's not good.
It was expensive too. It was like if I remember correctly, it's like $150 to $180 to buy that ring.
That's a lot of money.
Yeah.
It really is. I remember WCW, and WWE did this too. They would come out with play sets with their action figures. So they had, you build your own ring.
Yeah.
With WCW, and it had Booker T, had Bret Hart.
Oh, the figures. That, yep. Yeah,
and
okay.
And it came with a corner of the ring.
Yeah,
and you can make it. And I thought that was kind of a cool idea.
Yeah.
WWE kind of answered back with their figures, but their ropes were stiff, where the WCW ones weren't.
Right.
So you could actually have a match compared to what WWE did.
Had those. I can't remember, though. So did they have it where the ring was obviously smaller,
yeah,
right? Now, did they come with the ropes to go all the way around?
It did.
I had all the figures.
Yep, it did come with
I
the ropes and
remember.
Everything, yeah.
Yeah.
And they actually had, I think it was either five or six guys. I know Steiner was in that
Steiner,
series.
Two of them. They had two Steiners.
Yep.
They had them in white, and they had them in black.
Yep.
I believe they had I think they had two of everyone. They had two Booker T's, right? I think they had one in red and one in white. And then they had
know white for
they
sure.
They had two Benoits. They had them in red, and then they had them in blue. And then they had a Hitman, but I don't know if they had two Hitmen.
Yeah, I
know. No, I think maybe they had a Hitman in it was either a Luger or a DDP, right?
DDP was one.
Okay, yep. So one Hitman and one DDP.
But it was odd because it wasn't enough to build an extra ring.
Yeah.
Like you were off pieces.
Okay.
And those boxes were horrible. They never put enough glue on. That was the era where they didn't want to glue their boxes together.
Yeah, you'd see like the ring part on the shelf and the
And I remember WWE came out with Grunge Match, and it was the little tiny figurines with the ring.
Right.
And I kind of thought it was a cool idea because you could take the ring out and display them in it. I think rings as a whole is a really cool idea. I think one thing WWE AEW, nobody's picked up on this, and I think it would be a phenomenal idea, and if it happens, you hear it here first, have an autograph ring. A lot of people, and now kids are even doing this now, they will grab a ring, they'll take down the ropes, everything, and it'll just get the canvas signed. And it's so many people are doing that now because it's cheap to buy, especially like one of these end rings, they're like 10, 12, 15 bucks.
Yeah.
They're starting to go up a little more now, but they're the generic rings, to just get them signed. And it's a nice collage.
That's a cool idea.
Do an autograph ring.
You know what
I mean?
You know what's funny, funny enough, is where do we store the rings in our house? On the wall. We have nails on the wall, and Nathaniel hangs them up because you can't really stack them. So we do have, like the He-Man ones we have hung on the wall. Real quick, I know he's going to be like, but the Jax line did release Rocky rings.
You're trying to get Rocky in.
But, hey, they're rings, though.
Hey, I told you, if you get the meat figure, Green, okay, we'll
okay,
talk
about
that.
How about this?
That.
Since it's on figures, write in, please, and tell us. I would love to do a Rocky figure line.
If we show. Right, we'll do this. If we get five real people.
Five. All okay, I need is five.
Okay, five people to write in and say they're very interested in the line, explaining why this can't come from him or anybody that knows him, and he gets the meat figurine.
Well, I'm not doing that. Okay. I don't know how much that costs.
And you get that. We'll do a show on Rocky.
Would you not like to see the Rocky line from Jax on here?
I'm not saying
it would be so good. I have almost all the figures.
It's just not wrestling right now.
It doesn't matter. It's Figures, Inc. Figures are us.
Yes,
it's a great line. Hulk Hogan's in it. Yes. Mr. T. Anyway,
so do you
there
know,
was some rings
so
released for Rocky.
You brought up Mr. T. Do you know, not Mr. T, in the Rocky movie, you know, the Russian guy.
Ivan Drago.
Yeah. Do you know who was supposed to be playing that role?
Who was supposed to?
There was three people in line for that role. He was the third person. Do you know the other two?
I mean, I probably do off the top of my head. I can't think who. Like, you tell me and I'll tell you.
All right. So number two was Nikolai Volkov.
Well, that would have been horrible.
Yeah.
Next.
Number one, Texas Tornado.
Really?
Yep. He was in the front running for that.
Well, they picked the right one out of the three, I'll tell you that.
He did nail the role perfectly.
Nikolai Volkov is Ivan Drago. Oh, man. Anyway, there was a Rocky ring. I had it. I gave it to one of my younger cousins when they had a house fire. He needed some toys, so Rocky ring went to him, and any other figures I had at the time went to him. But, you know, it was just much like it was just the same ring. Just basically new stickers on it, you know?
Yeah, you really can't do anything with the ring compared to adding features like a the cage, adding snakes to the corner, changing up the color. They did, however, in your rope process, you need to have these nice elastic ropes, not a heat elastic.
Once the
they
ropes,
did start with the ring with the bounce finish.
Right,
I'm kind of tossed up if I really like that feature or not. I get the idea of it.
I think it makes it more durable. They don't crack as much, I think.
Well, because the hard plastic rings were cracking and breaking. I think that's why they did that. I honestly, personally, wouldn't mind them coming back with, like, the, you know, LJN, your Hasbros, the hard plastic. You know, that was, you know, kind of like it reminded me of Rubbermaid. You know what I mean? Or Tupperware type of material. You know what I mean?
So they started also, like, Jack's really started. They started doing, like, once they did the real scale ring, then they started to do things like they had the Hell in the Cell play set.
Yep.
And then they had the Elimination Chamber play set.
Yep.
Now, did you ever see that, or do you have it?
I do have that.
You have that?
Yep.
Because that thing, I saw that actually in the Wrestling Figures, Inc. Building here in Rhode Island. Where was it?
It was in Cranston.
Yeah.
It was down
they had
in
it out.
Florida.
That thing was it was like the size of this table.
Remember
it was
the Pajami
like,
Jammer?
It was basically, getting that Elimination Chamber playset was basically like, in wrestling terms, getting the USS flag for G.I. Joe. It was, which I don't know if you know, because you only collect wrestling. But the USS flag.
Well, you could say Sergeant Slaughter was there.
Well, Sergeant Slaughter should get his own ring. Sergeant Slaughter was a wrestler, so maybe we should do G.I. Joe's. Anyway, they had a Roddy Piper G.I. Joe figure, too. They did.
We're not doing G.I. Joe.
Anyway. The USS flag was the gigantic where the airplanes land on it. aircraft carrier. But anyway, they had the Elimination Chamber. And then Mattel came in, and then they started. Was it Jax that was doing the rings, like the Hogan ring? Because Mattel also did it, too.
Jax was the one that started the
process. I almost did get that Hulk Hogan ring, because it was pretty cool.
It wasn't bad. Just to mention the Pajami prison one.
Oh, Pajami, yeah.
Yeah.
Did they release a playset?
They did. They actually had to pull it off the shelves because the original line only did one level around the ring.
So it was just like this?
It was like a single, and people did not like it. And it was big money. That was the first ring that they actually put a higher value to on in the stores. So they ended up coming out and they redid it so it formed kind of like how the Elimination Chamber was with different levels, layers.
You have to
layers
think, like, some of these rings, these are all my sons. Does he really need 6-7 rings? But it's like, you know, he's got this ring. Then I got this one to keep in the car so when he travels, he's always got this ring in the car to play with. And then it's like, well, got to get him the cage because, I mean, you got to have steel cage matches. And you think about it, it's hard to have a match in there.
It is.
The Punjabi match, you'd be trying to get your guys in. Like, you know what I mean?
Even with the Elimination Chamber. They started to actually do steel cages where the doors will be broke off. Or it's that you can put your hand in. And I actually kind of like that because it is very hard.
I like it, but I don't
do
because it's like, it's not legit, you know?
Exactly. And I think that's where my issue is with that, too. But it makes it a lot easier because my son used to be like, Dad, I can't play my figures. Like, it does get a little aggravating.
Mattel also released these two. Before you hit, I just wanted to close up with Mattel. These two Masters, they came out with the Masters of the Universe line. They came out with this one first, the Castle Grayskull. And I was just like, oh, man, I got to get that's so cool. The Snake Mountain one, so hard to get. It's so hard to find. So I just wanted to touch up on these. They're so cool. And that you were going to hit AEW.
Yeah, AEW. I'm going to give them credit where credit's due. And we don't talk that much about AEW, which I think.
Well, we did three shows on them.
Well, but
we got three dedicated shows.
We talk a lot more about WWE just because there's such more history and things you can relate to.
You're talking about 30 years.
The WCW rings, it is that hard plastic. It does hold up. What stinks about them is their turnbuckles, poles. They break so easily. So
I
that's
can see them getting loose
like.
On this one.
Oh, we went through three already in my house. And
they also have
they don't last long.
They also have released now, AEW has released their own real scale rings now, too. Yeah. And they come with an exclusive figure.
That's where credit is due. Yeah. A lot of them always, I don't think there's one ring that they release besides this particular one that does not come.
That one did. So, they do have the basic.
Yep.
This one actually was a UK exclusive because I had to get the special Cody Rhodes that came with it. But just in general, you can go to Walmart and pick up the ring for 20.
Besides that particular one that you can get for 20, they all come with something.
Right.
So at least you're getting something, and I like that.
It's just like back in the day with G.I. Joe and Star Wars. With G.I. Joe, you bought the vehicle, you're getting a figure. Star Wars, you never got an extra figure with it. AEW, you get the figure with the ring. WWE, you don't.
So let's kind of wrap it up. Is a wrestling ring a great gift for somebody, for a collector, or for somebody you don't know and your mom, dad, grandparents?
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Because even if they collect,
they're gonna
even if they
it.
Just collect and say they open them up and put them on the shelf, you can have the ring and they can be standing in the ring.
Remember this too. The rings get beat up. They're always going to look like garbage afterwards if they're getting used. A kid will always love and have an extra ring. They make matches on TV with two rings now, three rings now. Yep. You know what I mean? So the kid won't think, and they will just pull it and
the canvas?
It.
Yeah. Yeah. With the canvases.
So it's definitely going to be a safe bet that any kid will like. Even if they have it, they will soon use it.
You can't have a wrestling match without a ring.
Right.
You know?
In a collective value, you definitely, all rings are always going to be worth money no matter what the condition is. $10 ring back in the day, if it's beat up, ripped up, the ropes are all, you're going to get $40 down the line. There's always going to be money in rings.
Do you have a favorite ring of all time?
Yeah. My favorite ring of all time is the King of the Ring Hasbro ring.
All right. Interesting. Mine is the AWA ring, the red canvas with the steel cage. Every time I talk about it, I always talk about that little lock. I think that little lock is what makes it.
I think for me, the King of the Ring was that it was different.
You liked it better than the blue one?
So we got that ring. Me and my father was able to go to Hasbro's Toy Company, and we bought it right from there.
Yeah, because that's in Rhode Island, right?
Yeah. And if you work there, you could take family, friends in, and we knew somebody that worked there, and you get things dirt cheap. I got, I don't know, like 20-something Hasbro figures that day. It was nuts. And they were like 99 cents over there, brand new in package. And that's where we got the ring from. And that it was different. It's like, wow. They did, I don't know, it just caught my attention for some odd reason. Rings are definitely something that we're always going to want to be a part of.
I was going to say one last thing about
absolutely.
The AEW ring.
Go for it.
My son has the, they have like the arena set up too. It's all cardboard. And I know they're doing one for Raw too. It's like all cardboard.
Yes.
The stage and everything. So he has all that. So, I mean, it's not even just rings anymore. Now they're, like you can go to these special places online and buy like the arena. It's like, you know, like you could turn you could have the whole arena. It's not even just the ring anymore. You get a backstage areas. It's only going to progress more and more because kids want to have that stuff, like you were saying.
Yep.
They want to have that real life
what you said. I'll say check out the official Wrestling Museum coming up soon because we're going to really try to help out people, especially around the holidays and stuff like that. There's a lot of things in the works. Wrestling figures, rings, go together. Absolutely a great win. Make sure you guys take a smile up challenge. Smile while you're dumb up, help spread more smiles and hate in the world. Challenge other people to do the same. You can do it with your wrestling ring. And scan that QR code for us. Help us make a National Pro Wrestling Day totally free. It takes about 10 seconds to do. And you know what they say.
I guess in the case of a ring, keep checking those shelves.
See you next week, folks.